the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. A reading from the Gospel of Jesus Christ according to St. Luke. In the time of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah, who belonged to the priestly division of Abijah. His wife Elizabeth was also a descendant of Aaron. Both of them were upright in the sight of God, observing all the Lord's commandments and regulations blamelessly. But they had no children, because Elizabeth was barren, and they were both well along in years. The Gospel of the Lord. Elizabeth and Zechariah and their son John the Baptizer, they are the first New Testament characters we meet. They usher in a new era for us, who live so many years later. After Scripture's silence for 400 years between the old and the new, we finally are brought back to Israel, so changed from the last time we heard about it when we read the prophets of the Old Testament. Yet these three figures are as much Old Testament as they are new. They are transition figures, we might think of them. They take us from the old to the new, and along the way, things are revealed and salvation comes into focus a little more. It is no surprise, then, that Luke begins with Zechariah, the temple priest, and we even go into the temple with him on his day of service, when he is promised a baby boy from the angel Gabriel, and is struck mute, because he won't believe it without a sign. You see, his wife Elizabeth had no children, and she was well along in years. It would take a miracle. Yet in her old age, she did give birth to John. She is the last miracle mother in a long line of Old Testament women who craved a child but remained barren until God's intervention. Sarai and Hannah, just to mention only two. This temple priest and his barren wife, they are so Old Testament, faithfully waiting for God to come through with his promises, long-suffering and yet steadfast in faith. And what about their son John? Could he be more like Elijah? Could his message of repent for the kingdom is coming be more like his prophetic forerunners? He is in fact the fulfillment of Isaiah, a voice calling in the desert. These three, they are the last and perhaps the fullest of all the Old Testament figures. But still they lack clarity. Not as a testimony to God's law and gospel that is clear, but to who and when. And so in each case they give way to something even better. Zechariah's temple worship is replaced with the meal of actual forgiveness, no longer looking forward to that one day, the one day a sacrifice that would actually pay the price for sins, but a meal that points back to that sacrifice already done and hands forgiveness already earned. And Elizabeth, the miracle mother, gives way to an even more miraculous birth, not one of old age, but a birth from a virgin womb, Mary's. And John, his baptism is of repentance, but one comes who gives forgiveness in baptism, the fulfillment of all the Old Testament, the better John the Baptist, the better Adam, the better Moses, the better Joshua, Joseph, and all the rest, Jesus the Christ. And this Jesus that they usher in onto the scene on the pages of Scripture and onto the scene of your life, this Jesus is the better you. His righteousness replaces your unrighteous behavior. And so on this day that we remember that old and faithful couple, Zechariah and Elizabeth, the last of the old and the first of the new. Really, we remember Christ once again and how he used them and how he loved them and lifted them up to a startling degree and how he loves and forgives us, does what we could not do and never could, live perfectly, and then uses us as well, lifts us up to a startling degree. May we then have the same faith as Elizabeth and Zechariah, imperfect but made sure in Christ. May we be like their son and always point away from ourselves and to the one who fulfills it all, Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Dear Jesus, you came with a baptism of forgiveness for us. You have made us a part of your church along with John, Elizabeth, and Zechariah. May we honor you with our lives and always find comfort in your unending promise of grace. In your name we pray. Amen.